वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स. सो दिस इज द नेक्स्ट यूनिट दैट इज अबाउट द हीट एक्सचेंजर्स. सो इन दिस यूनिट बेसिकली वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द व्हाट आर द हीट एक्सचेंजर्स, व्हाट आर देयर क्लासिफिकेशंस एंड व्हाट आर देयर एप्लीकेशंस. सो दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ हीट एक्सचेंजर. द पर्पस ऑफ हीट एक्सचेंजर इज टू जस्ट टू ट्रांसफर अ हीट व्हेन the two fluids are in contact. So the main purpose is they remove heat from a fluid or they add heat to a fluid. So by using the heat exchanger, you can exchange heat from hot fluid to cold fluid, or you can also extract heat from a hotter fluid and transfer it to a colder fluid. These are the some of the examples of heat exchanger. First is intercoolers and preheaters. Second, condensers and boilers in steam plant. Third is condensers and evaporators in refrigeration units. Fourth is regenerators. Fifth, automobile radiator. Sixth is oil coolers of heat engine. Seventh is milk chiller of a pasteurizing plant. Eighth is several other industrial processes. Classification of heat exchanger. So generally we classify them. The first classification is based on nature of heat exchange process. So first is the either they are in direct contact or indirect contact. In the indirect contact, the recuperator and regenerator comes. So this is the this shows the that is the direct contact heat exchanger. In this direct contact heat exchanger, you can see the hot fluid and the cold fluid, they are having the direct contact. So you can see here that is your cold water enters and here hot water comes out. So in this form they are in direct contact. The examples of these type of heat exchangers are water cooling tower and jet condenser. Now the indirect contacts, the first one comes out, it is the recuperator. So in this recuperator, generally the fluid flows simultaneously on either side of a separating wall. The heat transfer occurs between the fluid streams without mixing or physical contact with each other. So this is how either the exchange of heat is without mixing or physical contact with each other can happen in this case of recuperator. These are the examples of the recuperators, that is the automobile radiators, oil cooler, intercooler, air preheater, economizers, superheaters, condensers and surface feed heaters of a steam power plant, milk chiller of pasteurizing plant, evaporator of an ice plant. So there we find their applications. Advantages of these recuperators are they are having the easy construction, more economical, more surface area for heat transfer and much suitable for stationary plants. Disadvantages, that is the less heat transfer coefficient, less generating capacity and soothing problems are there. Next classification in this case of indirect comes from the regenerator. In the regenerator, the hot fluid is passed through a certain medium called matrix. The heat is transferred to the solid matrix, accumulates there. The operation is called heat period. The heat thus stored in the matrix is subsequently transferred to the cold fluid by allowing it to pass over the heated matrix. In the case of examples are that is the IC engine and gas turbine, open hearth and glass melting furnaces. Generally, the performance of the regenerator is affected by the following parameters. First, it should have a heat capacity of regenerating material, the rate of absorption, and the release of heat. Advantages are they are having higher heat transfer coefficient. Second is less weight per kilowatt of the plant. Third advantage is minimum pressure loss. Fourth is quick response to load variation. Fifth is small bulk weight. Sixth is efficiency quite high. Disadvantages, that is they are costly compared to recuperative heat exchangers and the leakage is the main trouble. Therefore, perfect sealing is required in this case of regenerators. Thank you, students, for listening.